After 3 decades with the team, head scout and assistant general manager Lauren Frey is leaving, so it's time for a little reflection.
Well, it's tough, but it's time, Kent. It's time. We've been here, like you say, basically 30 years, and I put my time in, and my wife and I had a discussion. I've been away a lot, and certainly, you know, as you get on in life, you have to, you know, make choices, and our choices to basically now go back to Swift Current and be with our family, and it's time, and we're looking forward to that.
He's lived with us through the good times and the bad, and you know, he was with us when we started this team. He was part of the dream, and then, you know, going through the hard times of when we first moved here, hoping that it would succeed, and then you know, the Memorial Cup that was hosted here, he was part of that, and then the other four we've been to, he's, you know, been instrumental in helping us build those teams.
You lead the team at an interesting time where I think a lot of moves were made to try to pull a team together that needed to improve to host the Memorial Cup, and now it's not happening, and yet those moves were made. It's a bit of a tough moment for the team, and how does it feel to leave them when maybe you're kind of needed?
Well, I'm not actually leaving them. I'm still going to be around for at least another year, and I'm going to help with Bruce and developing our team for the next year, and Chris and our coaches. I think we've already made up our mind. We did do a lot of dealing last year. We gave up some top picks, but we kept one good thing about it. We kept our good young prospects. We never traded our good young prospects. So I think people are you know, forgetting that. Like, I know when Swift Current, Regina, and those teams traded for Memorial Cups, they traded all their good young prospects. We haven't been able to do that. We've been able to keep Tyler Wong and Nolan Flamand and individuals like that, where those other teams weren't able to. So, you know, so we think now we're at the stage we realize next year is going to be a bit of a rebuild. We know we're going to have to get bring in some young players, 16, 17-year-olds, and live with them for a year. But we are confident in the ability of a lot of these young kids, and we think we'll still be competitive, and in a year or two's time, we'll be back to having a real good, successful hockey team again.
Still, though, you are stepping aside from some of your main responsibilities here. But when I talk to you, I have the privilege to talk to a lot of people who have done amazing things in their lives. But what I see in you is someone who never really worked for a living, that you just got to do hockey for a lifetime.
That's a good point, because I say, some people say to me, well, you're going to retire. And I said, well, that's funny, because people says I've been retired for the last 30 years. So that's
been
a good point.
It has been fun for you, hasn't it?
Well, it's been a hoot. I mean, it's been fun. And I know we go through, when we travel and we go to all the tournaments and stuff, one of the comments a lot of teams make is how much fun our group has. Like, we're laughing, we're having fun, we're enjoying what we're seeing, and we've had a lot of fun. And Bruce and I, we've had a lot of fun times over the last 30 years, and during drafts and meetings and training camp and stuff like this. We've done a lot of fun things. It's just been a great time here, and it's going to be certainly a lot of memories.
All right, thanks for talking to us about it, Lauren Frey.
You bet, Kent. Thanks very much.
From his home in Swift Current, Lauren Frey will be taking on the designation of senior advisor. At age 70, Bruce Hambleton says that's a position he's earned. For Kelowna Now, this is Kent Molgat reporting.